Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. I welcome you on Sanjay Gupta Tech School. In this video, I am going to explain how you can print these series on output screen. So if you see carefully, so here x upon y square, then plus x cube upon y raised 4, then again plus x raised 5 and y, sorry, x raised 5 upon y raised 6 is there, and this will go so on. So if you see the numerator, its power is 1, 3, 5, 7, and so on. If you see the denominator, its power is 2, 4, 6, and so on. So numerator x will be having power as odd value, and denominator y will be having power as even numbers. Now, if we see the second series, so digits x and y are same, powers are same. The only difference is here it will print all plus, plus, plus. But here it will print first value as plus, second as minus, then plus, then minus, and so on. So we can do two operations on these series. Either we can print the terms evaluated here as x upon y square, then x3 upon y4. And second, what we can do, we can add all the calculated results and then print, then can print a particular value, right? So we will do both. So first I'm going to pick this one, and then I will convert that implemented program for this plus minus sequence, right? So I'm starting the program. So here I'm going to use some variables. So I, then n, n will be reading the value like how many terms you want to print or add. Then we have power, so I'm having P as 1, Q as 2. So P will be storing the power of numerator X, and Q will be storing the power of denominator Y. So P started from 1, Q started from 2, because X is having power as 1, and Y is having as 2. Now I'm declaring two float variables, X and Y, because I am going to divide them, so there will be possibility they will have results in decimal point. That's why I declared them as float. Now I am writing printf scanf so that we can read values of x, n, and y from user. So enter x, y, and n. Then scanf %f, %f, %d, ampersand x, ampersand y, ampersand n. So two are float, that's why percent f, one is integer, that's why percent d, and this is the variable. Now I'm going to implement a for loop. It will repeat n times. It will repeat n times, right? So now I'm going to calculate this first. So it is x raised 1 and y raised 2. So I'm going to calculate numerator first, then denominator. So let's say I'm using capital N for a numerator value equals to P or W X comma, and here I'm passing P. So X is the base and P is the power. So right now P is 1. So X raised 1 will be calculated and result will be stored inside N variable. Then I'm going to calculate denominator. So P or W, Y comma Q. So Y is the denominator and its power is Q, that is 2 right now. So it will be calculated. Then R equals to N upon D. This is calculated, right? Now I told you, we need to print this calculated result as well as we need to print the sum. So calculation is available in R for this equation. So now I'm going to use one more variable, that is S equals to S plus R. So S will be having sum of all the expressions, and immediately we need to print result that is stored in R as well, right? So after this, I'm going to print percent F, and after this I'm mentioning a plus, and then the value which is stored inside R. So R is having a calculated result, so that is printed with the help of percent F here. Now after this, I need to increase value of P as 3 and value of Q as 4. So here I am writing P equals to P plus 2. P equals to P plus 2. And after this, Q equals to Q plus 2. And remember, here you need to put semicolon. So P will be 3 and Q will be 4 because their initial value is 1 and 2 respectively. So accordingly, they will be incremented, right? And after this, I can close this for loop. So this for loop will be printing each terms. So let's say X is 3 and Y is 2. X is 3 and Y is 2. So 3 upon 4, whatever will be the result, will be displayed on output screen, and then plus. This sign will be displayed. Then next time, X is 3. So 3 raised 3 upon 2 raised 4, and then a plus. So this expression result will be printed, and along with plus sign will be printed. So this way, the series will be printed. Now, after completion of this loop, you want to print the sum of this whole series that we are storing inside S variable. So after completion of this loop, you can print sum equals to percent F and S, and then you can complete the program. And remember to use backslash n so that will be printed on new line. So S will be having sum of all the expressions, so that will be printed on output screen. So now I have used some more variables, so I'm declaring them here, n, d, r, and s, and I'm initializing it as 0.0 because I'm using it to add the result. So that's why I'm initializing it with 0.0. So this way, I hope you understood the implementation. So let's iterate it so that we can understand it more easily. So X is 3, Y is 2, then P is 1, Q is 2. So these are the initial value, and here we can write S is 0.0. Now this is done, then I will start from 1. This will be calculated, so X comma P. So X is 3 and P is 1, so 3 raised 1 will be calculated, result will be in N. Then POW will calculate Y comma Q. So Y is 2 and Q is 2. So 2 raised 2 will be calculated, result will be stored in D. Both will be divided, result will be in R. R will be added to S, and then percent F plus. So 3 by 4 result, and then plus will be printed. And P will become 3 and Q will become 4 by this. Then I will be incremented for second rotation. So X is same 3, P is now 3. So 3 raised 3 will be calculated and stored inside N. Then Y is 2. So 2 raised 4 will be calculated and stored in D. Again, they will be divided and result will be stored inside R. R will be added to S. And after that, R will be printed on output screen with this plus. So this way, the result will be printed here and then plus. So accordingly, this iteration will be executed based on the value of n. So let's say n is 5. So 5 expressions will be calculated, and their result will be displayed in terms of series with the help of this printf, and in terms of sum with the help of this print. Right? So I hope you understood how we can implement this kind of series with the help of C program. So this is looking very difficult, but when we start implementing it, so it's very easy. Now, after implementation of this series, we need to implement this. So I'm going to give you a brief idea how you can implement this. Then you can modify this program easily. So here you can see this is the odd term, first expression. This is even, this is again odd. Then now if we see the pattern, so odd is having plus, this odd is having plus, but even is having minus. So if we go beyond this, so again we will be having minus x raised 7 upon y raised 8, right, and so on. So you need to check the value of I. If I is odd, we need to do plus operation. If I is even, we need to do minus operation, right? So here I am printing it like this, percent f plus. So now you can use this plus sign before printing this expression and based on value of I. So every time we need to calculate these. So I am going to modify this right now so that you will understand how it will be implemented. So this is odd, then even, then odd, and so on. So this will be same. This will be same. Then we need to divide this. It will be same. But here we need a plus or minus operation based on their positions. So these two will depend upon value of I. S equals to S plus R and this printf statement, right? So let's say I am also removing these from here and now here you need to write this. If I modulus 2 double equals to 0, then two statements and else two statements, and this block you need to write here. Right, so this block will be implemented here, and then you can use these statements as it is, and this will be same. So if I is divisible by 2, it means we are going to do this. So we need to print minus sign, then expression result, and if we implement addition or subtraction, then that will again depend on this. So here I am writing this. So because this is even position, so I am implementing S equals to S minus R. I am subtracting it. And here I am writing printf, then minus percent f and R. So value of R will be printed. Value of R will be printed in place of this percent f. And before that, this minus sign will be printed. Now if we talk about odd term, so S equals to S plus R. So odd term will be added into S, and printf will print plus percent f and then R. So this way you can decide which position you are printing or you are calculating. So if you are calculating odd position, so it will be added and printed with a plus sign. If you are on even position, so it will be subtracted from S and will be printed with a minus sign. So this way it works. I hope you understood both the implementations. So use this if and else here, and rest of the code will remain same for this series and for the previous one. The two statements that you noticed which were written before this implementation that you need to use. So implement both in your system so that you can understand how these series can be printed. So I explained you both the things. First, to print the series with the help of this printf inside loop. Second, to print sum of all the expressions using this printf that is outside the loop, right? So I hope you understood whatever I explained in this video. If you want to watch more programming related videos, you can open my channel, go to playlist and see whatever you want. So thank you for watching this video.